Hello, I'm Father Anthony Cekada. Welcome to broadcast number 6 for the Philothea Press bestseller, Work of Human Hands, a Theological Critique of the Mass of Paul VI, by the Reverend Anthony Cekada. To order Work of Human Hands and to read excerpts, visit www.philotheapress.com. Chapter 6, the 1970 General Instruction, the Cleverness of the Revisers. Paul VI promulgated his new Mass on April 3, 1969. By this time, conservative Catholics, they would later be called traditionalists, had endured 5 years of liturgical changes after Vatican II. To them, each stage seemed to bring the Mass closer to Protestantism and closer to the teaching of the modernist theologians. In August 1966, 6 Protestant clergymen, some of whom are shown here greeting Paul VI, were invited to serve as observers as the Vatican agency responsible for liturgical change, Concilium, went about its work of overhauling the Catholic liturgy. When the new order of Mass and the general instruction finally appeared in 1969, Protestantism and the new theology seemed to have triumphed. But what to do? In the conservative camp were two members of Roman high society, Emilia Pediconi and Vittoria Guerini. The latter was a poet, a writer, and a translator who wrote under the pseudonym of Cristina Campo. Both women were friends of Alfredo Cardinal Ottaviani, who had by then retired from his post as prefect of the Holy Office, and both women had wide connections in ecclesiastical circles. These determined women used their contacts to bring together a small group of conservative theologians, liturgists, and pastors, who decided to prepare a critical study of the new order of Mass. Cardinal Ottaviani agreed to revise the study and to present it to Paul VI. The group met a number of times in April and May 1969. The task of preparing a suitable text fell to a Dominican theologian and philosopher, Father M. L. Gerard de Laurier, then a professor at the Pontifical Lateran University in Rome. The result was a short critical study of the new order of Mass, Breve Esame Critico del Novus Ordo Missae, now known in English-speaking countries as the Ottaviani Intervention. Cardinal Ottaviani composed a covering letter to Paul VI, which supported the study's conclusions. The organizers, among them Archbishop Marcel Lefebvre, lined up a large number of high-ranking ecclesiastics, including a dozen cardinals, to sign the letter along with Cardinal Ottaviani. Ottaviani spent several days examining the critical study and signed it on September 13, 1969. Unfortunately, the secrecy of the project was compromised the next day. This scared off the rest of the signers, except for Antonio Cardinal Bacci, a prelate who did not scare easily. He had earlier written a laudatory preface to a book that condemned the liturgical reform and called the cardinal who headed it Luther resurrected. Bacci signed on September 28th. The following day, the letter and the critical study were presented to Paul VI. The intervention offered a scathing theological critique of both the 1969 general instruction and the new rite of Mass itself. It condemned the new definition of the Mass as assembly, de-emphasis on the Mass as a sacrifice of propitiation, the reduction of the priest's role, implicit denials of the real presence and transubstantiation, and countless other details in the instruction and in the rite itself. A major controversy ensued. At first, the reformers denied that the general instruction was a theological or a doctrinal statement. This was a lie. As I demonstrate in Chapter 6 of Work of Human Hands, before the controversy, the Reformers themselves had repeatedly said the instruction would explain the theological and doctrinal principles behind the new Mass. In two audiences in November 1969, Paul VI publicly defended the orthodoxy of the new Mass. In a further attempt to quell doctrinal objections to the new Mass, the Vatican issued a new 15-paragraph foreword, or premium, to the Missal, aimed at defending the orthodoxy of the new rite. The Vatican also issued a revised version of the 1969 General Instruction. The procedure was to insert a Tridentine term alongside many of the terms in the General Instruction that the intervention had condemned as Protestant or modernist. You can see this method at work in the revised version of Article 7, the definition of the Mass. The Tridentine terms that were inserted are highlighted in red rectangles and placed alongside the Protestant or modernist terms, which are highlighted with blue circles. The terms are equated, leaving the impression that one is free to understand the Mass either way, as a sacrifice or as an assembly supper. The end result was enough to fool many conservatives, but ambiguous enough to accommodate ecumenism and modernist theology. One member of Concilium, however, gave the game away. Father Emil Lengeling, a German theologian, liturgist, and ecumenist, cynically boasted that the 1970 instruction still kept us out of the dead end of the post-Tridentine theories of sacrifice, thanks to what he called the cleverness of the revisers. And he had a lot to crow about. For despite the cosmetic changes in the instruction, the prayers and rites of the 1970 Order of Mass are identical to those of the 1969 Novus Ordo Missae. Thus, the episode of the 1970 General Instruction was nothing more than a little game played on paper. It was as if an architect had designed a building that promptly began to collapse, and he solved the problem by scribbling a few changes on his original blueprints and then putting them back into a drawer. What the architect drew on his defective blueprints does not change the structure that he actually built, and it sure won't keep the bricks from falling on someone's head. The only real solution is to dynamite the collapsing building and to haul away the rubble. The key to understanding the theology behind the Mass of Paul VI, now used in our cathedrals and parish churches, therefore, lies not in the pseudo-Tridentine foreword and general instruction of 1970. Rather, we find it in the general instruction of 1969, a document based on the modernist assembly theology of Louis Bouillet, itself founded on the writings of the Lutheran ecumenist Inga Brilliot. If your Mass is the new Mass, these men provided the theology behind it. To find out more about the Ottaviani Intervention and the 1970 General Instruction, read The Cleverness of the Revisers, Chapter 6 of Work of Human Hands, A Theological Critique of the Mass of Paul VI. Our next chapter, Ready for Assembly. To order Work of Human Hands and to read excerpts, or to order the new 2010 edition of the Ottaviani Intervention, visit www.philotheapress.com.